revenge travel, set jetting, destination dupes, dry tripping. 2024 is going to be such an exciting travel year that they've had to come up with new words to describe it. Important news and trends coming up. Hi, it's Melissa here at Ready to Go, where we discuss tips and resources to help you plan your very own travels and create unforgettable memories and experiences. Welcome to 2024, everyone. As we enter the new year, I wanted to do an episode giving you some important travel news and trends for the year coming up. Namely, will the high travel demand and high prices we saw in 2023 continue into 2024? What's going on with the new European travel authorization? Why you'll need to book very soon if you want to visit the Norwegian fjords? And the most anticipated new cruise ships coming out this year. Also, do you know what these three brand new terms mean? Stay tuned till the end and we'll learn all about these three brand new travel trends. Now, I want to keep making videos that help you with your travel plans. So if you have any travel news that you'd like me to look up or comment on, please write it up in the comments below. So our first item, they call it revenge travel. After the travel industry took a hit between the years 2020 and 2022, there's a survey called the Global Rescue Traveler Sentiment and Safety Survey, and it found that 80% of frequent travelers took as many or more trips in 2023 than at any previous time before the pandemic. A report by Statista also found that air travel in 2023 was up by 29% versus 2022, and international travel was up by as much as 50%, according to the International Air Transportation Association. So, bottom line, people want to go places and see the world. So, what's it looking like for 2024? Well, it's a fact that travel demand is set to remain high, and probably the prices as well. So what about all this inflation? Well, a recent study by Hilton confirmed that 64% of global travelers say that they aim to reduce other areas of their personal spending in order to prioritize travel in 2024. And this is especially true for Gen Z and millennials who plan to spend more on travel in 2024 than in previous years. There's also an annual travel study done by the company Alliance that found that age 55 plus travelers will be back to pre-pandemic travel numbers, and there's a new record expected for 2024 summer travel spend. And all this despite inflation and the economic downturn. So we're definitely going places, people. Okay, so the second thing I wanted to talk about was the new European Travel Authorization, ETIAS. And this has now officially been delayed to early 2025. So what's the ETIAS? It's sort of a pass that allows non-EU members to travel to countries of the European Union, and this includes a list of 30 countries. I'll put a link in the description below that'll give you a list of all the applicable countries. And obviously, this will be required for travelers who are residents of the UK, the US, and Canada. So based on the info we have today, there will be a fee of €7 per traveler, and this pass will be valid for 3 years once it's issued. Now, important to know that this isn't a visa, but rather a travel authorization. So for those who may not be familiar, since 2008, European travelers coming to the US for business or leisure purposes had to fill out what we call an ESTA form. So the reason behind the ETIAS is very similar to ESTA, and this is for travel between countries that don't require you to have a visa to enter. And the official reason is that these passes provide an additional level of security since a visa is not required. They sort of do a quick background check and also ask you your reason for traveling. So this information is captured as data and remains online in their system, which is obviously very different than how you would travel to Europe today, where you just flash your passport and maybe they put a stamp in it and you're on your merry way. So most ETIAS requests will be approved within a matter of just minutes online, though it can take up to 96 hours. So there is this sort of growing trend of electronically tracking travelers' movements, and this may cause some concern with people. So the question I always have is, okay, these are very legitimate security reasons, but once this information is stored, what guarantees us that it won't be used for other purposes in the future? So we'll just leave it at that. But how about you? What's your opinion on these digital travel tracking systems? Let me know in the comments below. Next item is cruising the Norwegian fjords, which is often a bucket list item for many cruisers. Well, Norway has confirmed that as of 2026, only non-emission ships will be able to cruise through the major fjords. And as of today, there aren't many large cruise ship companies that have ships that respect that requirement. However, Norway has been developing ships that are completely electric. So there will still be options to cruise the Norwegian fjords, but I would say many less options than there are today. So if you want to cruise the Norwegian fjords, book now so that you can do it either in 2024 or 2025. Okay, our next item, new cruise ships galore this year. If you try to book a cruise for a time frame within the next 6 months, you'll notice that cabin availability is very limited. Most cruises are sailing at full capacity, so that drives up the price. So to meet the increasing demand, most cruise lines are launching new ships this year. First and foremost, in January, we have the Icon of the Seas by Royal Caribbean, which will become the world's biggest cruise ship. It will hold up to 7,600 passengers plus 2,300 crew members. It's 1,200 feet long. That's the equivalent of 3 football fields. It will have the largest water park at sea with 6 slides and over 40 venues for eating, drinking, and entertainment. There's a reason they're calling it the Icon of Vacations. In February, Princess will be bringing their new Sun Princess to the market, and they will have 3 brand new shows on board by the Cirque Éloise, an international circus company, and all new themes for game shows, deck parties, and redesigned glass-enclosed areas such as the Piazza and the Dome. In May, Cunard will be launching Queen Anne, its first new ship in 12 years. Now, Cunard offers more of a classic cruise ship experience, a little bit more formal, with afternoon tea and such. And they offer lots of transatlantic itineraries. In July, Royal Caribbean will be launching Utopia of the Seas, which will be the last of its Oasis-class ships. And this one will be interesting in terms of itinerary, as they'll be offering 3-day and 4-day sailings to the Bahamas. So for those who are not used to cruising and just want to try it out, or you want a quick 4-day getaway, this will be a great option to try it out on a brand new cruise ship. Now, in the luxury cruise market, in July, we have Silver Sea launching its Silver Ray, which is all luxury cabins with butler service. That would be nice. In August, Explora Journeys, which is the new luxury line by MSC, will launch its Explora 2. And Explora 2 will have all ocean-facing suites, and they promise high levels of personal service and unique destinations. And finally, in December, Disney will be launching the Disney Treasure, which is the sister ship to the Disney Wish. It will have an Aladdin theme, it will feature 10 separate pools, a water coaster at sea, and for those who don't know, Disney ships have a surprising number of adult-only areas as well. Other notable mentions are the Ritz-Carlton Yacht Collection that will be welcoming its second ship, the Ilma. Viking will have the new Vela, which will have 17 additional cabins versus their older ships. So for those interested in river cruising, Amma Waterways will be adding a second ship to its Nile River itinerary in Egypt. The new ship will be called the Amma Lilia. And they've also developed an entirely new itinerary in Colombia on the Magdalena River, sailing aboard the new 60-passenger ship, the Amma Magdalena. And finally, Avalon will bring river cruising to Portugal along the Douro River with its Avalon Alegria. Okay, so now that we've got all the important travel news covered, what about those 3 new travel terms and what do they mean? Just before we get to that, if you're finding this video interesting and informative for you, please give it a big like right now. Okay, so the first new travel term of the year, destination dupes. What is a destination dupe? Well, destination dupes are cheaper destinations that are very similar to their more expensive alternatives. Some examples of this include in the Caribbean, the island of Curaçao as a dupe for St. Martin, Perth, Australia as a dupe for Sydney, and Paros, Greece as a dupe for Santorini. You can just Google travel dupes for more ideas. The next term is set jetting, where travelers tend to visit locations that they've seen in their favorite movies or TV shows. And in fact, over 50% of searches on Expedia are now for set jetting destinations. So some examples of set jetting are, for instance, Venice Beach, California, which was featured in the Barbie movie. You have Hobbiton, New Zealand from Lord of the Rings, the island of Sicily in Italy from the White Lotus show, and Dubrovnik, Croatia, where much of Game of Thrones was filmed. And now the third term, dry tripping. Dry tripping refers to the trend towards sober travel. And this trend is actually led by millennials and Gen Z, which would be anyone born after 1981. So for older generations, approximately 60% of people consider themselves as regular drinkers. So I guess it's good news because only 21% of Gen Zs consider themselves regular drinkers. So the travel industry has responded to this with hotels, bars, and restaurants offering more mocktail menus as well as non-alcoholic beers and wines. So that wraps up our 2024 travel news and trends. If you found it helpful, again, please smash that like button. Now, next week, we'll be talking about travel bucket lists and also what is my next upcoming trip. All I can tell you at this moment is that it will give you tons of new, interesting, and entertaining content. So please check that out next week. So to make sure you never miss out on new videos, please consider subscribing to the channel and turn on the notifications bell. This way, you make sure you're always ready to go.